everyone. My name is Harry. I'm here at Criswell Chevrolet of Gaithersburg, Maryland. Today we'd like to go over some of the accessory items that we have, in particular nitrogen. And I have Mike McCormick here. He's our service manager. Mike, can you give us the rundown with nitrogen?
So nitrogen is great for your tires. It's going to allow you to be able to keep a more consistent pressure in your tire, which prevents against tire wear. Obviously, compressed air is going to expand when it gets hot, and it will condense when it gets cold. So nitrogen's a larger molecule. It's going to stay more consistent when you're in your tire driving.
You brought up some great points. How on earth did they discover that nitrogen is so beneficial for your tires?
So it's a great question. So nitrogen actually came from the use in the airline industry. So airlines took that from, you know, when you get it 30,000 feet up in the air, it gets very cold. Mm-hmm. So just like we were saying before, as compressed air condenses as it gets colder, it expands or it leaks out through the tire.
Right.
So obviously at 30,000 feet, there isn't a guy up there to reach over and go, hey, let me fill up your tires for you, right? So you land on the tarmac and you got a pretty bumpy ride at that point. So they decided, hey, let's try putting nitrogen in the tires, which then allowed to be able to keep a more consistent PSI in the tire.
Tires stay full the entire time upon takeoff
exactly.
and landing.
Which then, of course, from there, NASCAR, Formula One, MotoGP, everybody now uses it on race car tires as well, because we know those tires get very, very hot. They heat up, tires expand, and that's going to change the way fuel economy is. That's where they really kind of discovered, hey, this can help with fuel economy, because when you've got a car that's going 200 miles an hour down the racetrack, you want to be able to have consistent pressure in your tires as well at the same time. So not going to expand as much as well when you're driving. So you drive down the highway now in your Silverado, you're not going to have, tires aren't going to expand and go from 36 or 37 PSI to 45 PSI like it could do with compressed air if you're driving for extended periods of time.
So with compressed air in the springtime when it's cold in the mornings and it's warm in the afternoon, you see that fluctuation of PSI. Would the nitrogen prevent that?
It would. That's the perfect for our customers when they're coming in. It's great for that. You know, you're everything from a spark to a C8. You know, those customers that aren't driving as much right now during the pandemic as well, you want to know that you can get in the car, turn the car on and go, right?
Absolutely.
Not get in and go, oh, my tire light's on, now what do I have to do?
Right.
I got to go find some place to go get my tires filled up or somebody to check the tire, right? So now you don't have to have that concern. You can put nitrogen in the tires and away you go.
So not only does the tire light stay off in your vehicle, but it makes the tire last longer because the air is staying in a solid PSI, solid pressure.
Correct. So when you have, you know, for instance, and when you talk about longevity of the tire, if you've got one tire that's at 34, another one that's at 30, another one that's at 36, another one that's at 32, it's kind of like sitting at the kitchen table and you got a wobbly table, right? Same thing's going to happen with your car. You've got 6,000 pounds of metal sitting down on top of four uneven pressured tires. It's going to wear the tires prematurely.
Yeah, absolutely.
And tires are very expensive. They don't get cheaper every year. So tires are a big investment into the vehicle. So if you're keeping your air pressure consistent, which is an inexpensive way of being able to maximize the life of your tires.
All right, so this is the nitrogen machine. We actually have it hooked up to a airline that pushes air through the machine. The machine then converts it into nitrogen. We hook up one of these four tubes to each tire. The machine completely deflates each tire with the condensed air that's already in the tires, and then proceeds to put nitrogen in, ultimately giving you a better ride experience. Once that's all finished up, we put some green caps on. That way, any service lane or any shop will know that there is nitrogen in the tires. Ultimately, that avoids any type of confusion. So going over the machine, a good question that we should probably ask, can you combine nitrogen and the original condensed air together in the same tire?
That's a great question. So compressed air and nitrogen can be mixed inside the tire. Obviously, it's not recommended, but if you are in a situation where, you know, over time you have lost a few pounds of air in your tire and you're not someplace that you can put nitrogen in, you 100% can still put compressed air into the tire. It's not going to damage anything. It's not going to do anything harmful to anybody. It's still going to be safe, and it's safer to drive on air that's at the correct PSI inside the tire than it is to not have
the correct PSI.
Correct.
Right.
If you're interested in having your tires filled with nitrogen when you're in for service, it only costs $40. It's $10 a tire. So just ask any one of your service advisors.